Good evening friends, how are you? I'm fine and today I'm going to show you how to use CloudWatch event rule. So first of all, I'm going to create a Lambda function that will reboot the instances, and I will create a CloudWatch event rule so that the Lambda runs once in a day. That means it runs one day, anytime at the day. And the purpose of this event rule is to reboot the instance, because sometimes the instance becomes too much, CPU is becoming full, or sometimes automatically shut down. The reboot automatically event rule will automatically restart the instance. Okay, so there is a small Lambda function that is available, which I will give you in the description. It's simple. Let me copy the code, and then I'm going to create a new Lambda function here. I give the name is reboot instances. It needs to be in Python 3.8 or higher. It function. This will create the function. So let's wait for this. The process is smooth because it just takes 1 minute to create the Lambda function. Okay. So I will delete the existing code that's not required. I will paste the code, which I will give in the description. Two things we need to consider, that is the region US East 1. If you are using a different region than US East 1, please update that. And then the instance ID, which is also we need to change. Let's go to EC2. And then go to instances. Copy the instance ID. That's it. So I put the instance ID here. And that's it. Let's save the function. Okay, the function is saved. So what will happen if we run the function? This will reboot the instance, the ID, instance ID that we have given. That's the simple process, very simple function. Reboot the instance, that's it. And we want to run it once in a day, so that if our instance is like the memory is becoming full or anything hangs, after doing a reboot, it will refresh all the processes and it will start working fine. So we saved our Lambda function. We need to give the permission to the Lambda so that they can run the reboot the EC2 instance. For that, we need to go to configurations and permissions. There is an IAM role related to this Lambda. Let's click here. And I will give the Lambda permission to reboot the EC2 instance. So the process is attach policies. EC2 full. So I will give EC2 full access, attach policy. That's it. So our Lambda function now has permission to reboot instances. Now I'm going to go to CloudWatch. And then I'm going to create an event rule. Rules. Let's go to the left menu, click events, rules, create a rule. Okay. So here we are going to schedule fixed rate of 1 per day. That's it. Then we need to add a target. Click here, functions. This is the functions that we just created. Okay. So let's configure details, give it a name. instance, book the instance once per day, create rule. That's it. It's basically like a cron job, but inside AWS. So you can run this Lambda function with a, you can set a specific time as well, because they have cron settings as well. If, for example, rather than giving a fixed rate, you can give a cron expression. So you can learn here and see how to give a cron expression for a specific time. For example, if you want to run this Lambda function at 3 a.m. in the morning, you can do that using this cron expressions. I'm going to cancel it because I just created. For me, the time is not important. If it runs once in a day, that should be fine. That's the job. So I set up this event rule, and if I now go to functions and reload this function, go to details, it will now show you that yes, CloudWatch events is related to this Lambda. And in the monitor section, I can see when this Lambda function has been executed. So here it shows invocations one, actually. So it's already in launched once. And if I go to see view log in CloudWatch, I might see the details of what has been run properly. So here you see in the details that the status is success, and this is the request, and this has completed successfully. That's great, because I can just now come here and see if the execution was done properly. So that's it. That's it for today. I think this will help you to set up event rule in AWS. So event rule, by using event rule, you can basically set cron jobs to run Lambda functions, but it's not only Lambda, you can do other things as well. For example, you can run like, let's see, target we have. Yeah, SNS topic, SNS queue, SSM automation, Kinesis streams, even if this is code build project, code pipeline. So a lot of things you can do with event rule. It doesn't need to be a Lambda. You can do SNS topic, you can do SSM automations, a lot of things here. All those options are given here. Choose the one that is required for you. So that being said, that's it for today. I think this is a helpful tip for you. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. I beg you to subscribe to my channel, because I see a lot of people are viewing my videos, but they're not subscribing. If you do subscribe, I really appreciate, and I will create this more videos for you. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.